Hello and welcome to Factorio, or my submission to day 2 and 5 of Advent of Code 2019. So let's disable that. Let's keep the annoying light. That's there for a very special purpose. Let's reset and then load program 2. And we're gonna do part 1. So first I'm gonna load it. It takes a while. And now I have to get into address 1 the value of 12. And into value 2, address 2 the value of 2. So that's in there. Of course autosave. And then we gonna execute it. And I know from my Rust's implementation that this is the correct value. Let's reset. Let's go to day 5. Day 5. Let's load it. In the meantime, in the IO module, we will load the input 2. And then it's still loading. Let's execute. So you can see the instruction here. The first argument here, second argument, third argument. Or output address actually, and then you can see in this unreadable blue the first and here the second argument dereferenced, and this is dereferenced by relative base, but we are already done and I know this is the correct output. So let's get out of here and reset. And let's load program 5 again. And let's get a different input, which is 3. It loads for a second. And then we're gonna execute it. And we have a error. This is probably because I didn't reset it. I'm gonna reload the program anyway. It's pretty fast. Well, fast for a in-code computer in Factorio at least. Okay, let's try to execute it again. I might have Oh yeah, I have the wrong input. I thought that. Yeah. Okay. My mistake. Let's reset, let's reload. So, in day 5, the input determines the determines one instruction that you execute, so because it's self-modifying and I gave it the wrong input. Now we are talking, so this is day 5, part 2, executing on my in-code computer in Factorio. It halted with the correct output for day 5 part 2. I'm gonna disable it and reset it. Day 9 doesn't work because I used 32-bit integers, because Factorio combinators use 32-bit integers. But I'm gonna load another program, which is program 3, which I compiled from Benedict Werner's Incode compiler, and it's a faculty. It computes the faculty of 10 recursively. So that's then it uses relative base and parameter mode too. Let's reset and load. Loading program 3. And let's run it. So it will first output always the input to the faculty function, where we start at 10. And then go down to the base case of the recursion. Almost done. You can see now probably the stack unwinding, so it's returning from all those recursive function calls, decreasing the base. And this is the faculty of 10, so add relative base and parameter mode 2 works as well. And that's my Incode computer in Factorio. Bye.